Welcome back to the FedEx Forum, just moments away from tip-off.
Memphis looking to go to a remarkable 3-1. I mean, the fact that we're even talking about Memphis being 3-1 potentially in conference play is amazing.
It is truly amazing, and Coach McFerrin has been behind it, leading the charge
today. What a job that Melissa McFerrin has done with her team. She has a couple of transfers waiting in the wings for next year. A great recruiting class. Some services feel it's the top recruiting class for next season.
She's done an absolutely super job bringing in here players that have transferred from top 20 teams. They're big. They're strong.
Ferentz's team have been in most of the games they've played. Obviously a great start in Conference USA as they are 3-1. And right now, UAB is at the top at 4-0, 10-6 overall. East Carolina, a very good team, 15-3. But again, Rice knocked off East Carolina.
Right, and that shows you the strength of this conference. I think there really is some parity here. And even though Rice is in the bottom of the conference, they knocked off East Carolina. So this is going to be one of those seasons where on a given night, anybody can beat anybody.
We will be a championship team. We will compete for championships. We will get ourselves back in the NCAA tournament.
And the Memphis Tigers lead the Rice Owls 23-19.
Continuing here at halftime, Memphis leading Southern Miss 34-33. Memphis would be, I think, in dire straits if not for its defense and the fact that Southern Miss had a lot of turnovers that resulted in some Tigers points.
Well, Memphis defense is what kept them in this ball game early on because they did struggle in the half court against the zone. You can see Lonlack there getting a steal, getting out early. She's been impressive in this game with 9 points, 4 rebounds, and 3 steals. Very balanced for her. But then they started to find their way a little bit. Interior passing there by Bullard. Nice look. And Alex Winchell doing what she does so well, lighting it up for three. So they started to find their way against the zone, even though it didn't come early in the game.
So Southern Miss has to hurry, and they need a three. Danielle Johnson would be the one. Picked off. All the way to the cup. Whoa! The game is over. Memphis has won this ball game 60-57, but Lisa McFerrin is just worried about her.
47-42.
Don't waste any time.
Carter working against Koswitz.
Attack the rim.
She had the screen from Ellis, didn't take the pull-up. Now she does in the lane.
That's nice.
Makes the bucket. 8 rebounds.
Oh.
She can't make it a 2-point game. But Memphis gets the loose ball. They have an opportunity here. A three. Mumphrey with the inbounds. It's Buller. Now it doesn't look like they're going to foul. At least not now. Here's Carter. 19 to go. Carter double team.
Trapped her.
Carter in the lane. Actually on the baseline. Gets the roll. It's a 1-point game with 13 seconds to go.
12 seconds is a long time.
Winchell has not scored today. Smart. No. Short on the free throw. Here comes Memphis. 10 seconds to go. Down the court. Bullard is fouled. The chance to tie it now. You can see the agony on the faces of the Memphis Tigers. She knocks it down. We're tied at 47. Here comes Smart. Memphis has to avoid a foul. 2 seconds. Loose ball picked up by Bullard. And we are going overtime here at FedEx Forum. But it's picked up by Smart. 5 seconds to go. Mays tries to get it back to Smart. They're bobbling it in the backcourt. Picked up by Mays. Stolen by Kelsey. It is over. Unreal. Rice could not put a fork in that hot potato and get it past half court. They never got an opportunity to take a final shot. And Memphis survives 59-58. For Lynn Dunn, I'm Greg Gaston. What a ball game here at FedEx Forum in Memphis. Thanks for joining us as Memphis knocks off Rice 59-58. Stay tuned for more basketball as VCU takes on Northeastern right here. And have a great day, everybody.
We will prepare for the Conference USA season like every game matters because it does. That she gets to play the game of basketball during her senior. But what has happened with LaToya is she's getting used to every day more of what she's capable of doing. You see still right there. More of what she's capable of doing is starting the show. She's becoming comfortable with that. You see her there splitting the traffic. comes, and she's warming up a little bit from the three-point. Great winning jumper with 13 seconds left, or maybe not. Hopefully we'll for us on the road against a Big 12 team. And that will be the basket there. That's not her forte. Now, and we're going to rely on Alex a lot this year, and I think she's ready for the challenge. Next up is Taylor Mumfrey, who can extend her range, but in reality, lay up there. But our game was all about defense. She's going to go to the defensive and offensive boards. The other night, that's a wonderful job, and probably was the difference maker in the game with two rebounds. You see her there against the zone defense, and she's probably going to keep this for the rest of her life. Still in the open, Carter is one of the most team-oriented players that I've ever been around, and she's putting up big numbers for me after the game was over with. But it was more of a special night because it was a great win for us. You see the winning play right here. LaToya Bullard going off.
Talk about just the play when you play teams out of conference.
Along with the LaToya Bullard and Star Wellen right there, it simply strengthens the entirety of our team.
Defense really pulling you through in games like this.
Absolutely.
As the season goes on, you're really leaning on your defense to get things going. Is that something you
use as hard-nosed as any team you'll ever find defensively? Sometimes we're there, we're not gonna get a lot of them. See, you're taking short-range jump. Mostly Ramses Lunlatch is in charge of getting our defense started and getting in transition. And she is going to be a scorer from the minute you step foot on our campus. And she has not I'm pleased that she's been able to do it so effectively, so early. Shatia is very effective guarding the basketball. You see her there getting steals, and she likes playing that role. So another freshman that's contributing, getting significant minutes. Indiana or Missouri or an Ole Miss, an SEC team, and more physical game on the boards, in the post. I thought we matched up with them very well. Again, free throws were critical in that game. We had an opportunity to win the game if we'd hit another free throw or two, but in the end, literally, it came down to a loose ball that one of their players, it could have been a travel, it could have been later in the game. There's no question. If starters are logging too many minutes, and so therefore when we get without taking their entire Christmas break away from it, was up to handle the basketball, to shoot the basketball, and we were really excited to get off against Jackson State and really maintained our defensive intensity throughout the entire pretty good fashion.
You look at the highlights here and lots of steals going on in this.
Jackson State shoots only 29% from the field, which anytime we can hold teams to 29% from the field, we're going to have an opportunity. So certainly Brittany Carter had a big night, Ramses Nation. There's the likelihood that you're gonna give up some offside rebounds, but this is a double team. We held them to 55 points, 17 at the half, hit us on the boards a little bit, but the game plan was critical. And again, this is another game where we had a typical four. We saw a little bit of foul trouble. And so it's important. We want our signature to be our tough man-to-man did not create an opportunity for us to be the transition team that you see right here. Brittany Carter knocks down a pass in denial and takes it in the first half. We cannot do that. And it was very disappointing in our defense. But in the second half, we shored up a couple guards that were pretty tough to handle. And we had trouble keeping them out, began to take control of this game. 77-72, we talked points in the second half, 38 in the first, but we don't want to be a team that has to score out people. I like LaToya Bullard there, but a great conference win for us. Biggest challenge ahead for this team is becoming the team that we dream to be. And it's easy to say, there are a lot of steps in that process, but I think this team has the heart to be the team that we want to be even yet this year. We need to defend our home floor.
By golly.